സോ എവറി വീക്ക് നമ്മൾ വളരെ ഇൻസ്പയറിംഗ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ആൾക്കാരെ ആണ് ഇന്റർവ്യൂ ചെയ്യാറ്, പല ഫീൽഡിൽ നിന്നുള്ള. സോ ഇറ്റ്സ് ഫസ്റ്റ് ടൈം ഐ എം ഇന്റർവ്യൂയിങ് ആൻ ആർക്കിടെക്ട് ഹൂ ഇസ് ആക്ച്വലി ദ ആർക്കിടെക്ട് ആൻഡ് ഫൗണ്ടർ ഓഫ് വാൾ മേക്കർ. സോ വിനു, വെൽക്കം, താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച് ഫോർ കമ്മിങ്. സോ ലെറ്റ് സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ഫ്രം ദ ബേസിക് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ. എപ്പോഴും ആർക്കിടെക്ട് ആവണം എന്നുള്ള ഒരു ആഗ്രഹം ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നോ? എപ്പോഴായിരുന്നു ആ ഒരു ആഗ്രഹം വന്നത്? വാട്ട് ഇൻസ്പയർഡ് യു ടു ബി ആൻ ആർക്കിടെക്ട്?
എനിക്ക് ആർക്കിടെക്ചർ തന്നെ അറിയത്തില്ലായിരുന്നു. ഇത് അപ്പൊ എനിക്ക് ശരിക്കും പറഞ്ഞ ആർക്കിടെക്ചറിനെ കുറിച്ച് ഒന്നും അറിയത്തില്ലായിരുന്നു. ഞാന് നാട്ടില് മ്യൂസിക് പഠിക്കാൻ വേണ്ടി വന്നതാ. അപ്പോ എനിക്ക് വലിയ ആഗ്രഹമായിരുന്നു മ്യൂസിക് പഠിക്കണം. നോമന്റെ കുട്ടി ടീച്ചറിന്റെ അടുത്തൊക്കെ ഒരു വിധത്തിൽ ഞാൻ ക്ലാസ്സിലൊക്കെ കയറി, മാഡത്തിന്റെ പ്രൈവറ്റ് ട്യൂഷനിലൊക്കെ ഞാൻ കയറിയിരുന്നു. പക്ഷേ വീട്ടില് ഒരു എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് കോഴ്സ് ഭയങ്കര നിർബന്ധമായിരുന്നു, വീട്ടില് എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് കോഴ്സ് ചെയ്യാനുള്ളത്. അങ്ങനെ അവര് അപ്പം ഞാനിപ്പോ എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് കോഴ്സില് എന്താണുള്ള വരയായിട്ട് എനിക്ക് വരയ്ക്കാനറിയായിരുന്നു. അപ്പം വരയ്ക്കുന്നതായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട് ഒരു കോഴ്സ് എന്താണെന്നുള്ള നോക്കി വന്നപ്പോഴത്തേക്ക് ഇങ്ങനെ ആർക്കിടെക്ചർ അതിന്റെ ആപ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് ടെസ്റ്റ് ഒക്കെ എഴുതിയപ്പോഴും എനിക്ക് അതിനെ കുറിച്ച് വലിയ പിടുത്തമില്ലായിരുന്നു. കേറി കഴിഞ്ഞപ്പോഴാണ് അറിയുന്നത്. അപ്പോ താൽക്കാലികമായിട്ട് ഒരു കുടമാറ്റം എന്ന് മാത്രമായിരുന്നു ഞാൻ ഉദ്ദേശിച്ചിരുന്നത്.
ഓക്കേ. പക്ഷേ മ്യൂസിക് ആയിരുന്നു എപ്പോഴും ആഗ്രഹം.
പക്ഷെ അത് പിന്നീട് മാറി, കാരണം ഇതെല്ലാം ആർട്ടാണല്ലോ. അപ്പൊ ആ ഒരു ഒരു കാഴ്ചപ്പാടില് മുന്നോട്ട് ചേർന്നു.
Tell us about the beginning of Wall Makers, your firm.
Wall Makers was actually not something which I gave the name. Wall Makers was the name given by my brother. My brother Praveen, who was with me during my initial times, because initially we had nobody to help this concept.
Okay.
I wanted to do mud buildings, and obviously your younger brother is your first victim, you know.
Okay.
So you pull him in whatever you do, you know. He is free labor.
So
once some prospective client came to our site, and this guy said, we have a 5-acre property. So we were reduced to doing compound wall at that particular point of time, because nobody believed that mud buildings could be, you know, houses at that particular point of time. This was difficult. So my brother was expecting a huge project in terms of 5-acre and everything, but suddenly the guy said it's a compound wall. So in his dissatisfaction, you know, so this guy asked, do you guys do houses, you know, so he said something like that, no, we only do walls, we are wall makers, you know. So that is how the name came. Later the name stuck on, and I never intended our firm to become something like a pure single person entity, you know. Something like Vinu Daniel firm or nothing like that. I always wanted it to continue, you know, carry on the principles is what I aspire. So Wall Makers was actually a derogatory term at that point of time. I hated it, you know, but later it stuck out.
So how has the earth architecture, how has it evolved for you through the years in your work?
See, the thing is, more than earth architecture, the reason why I started it was because, you know, like I came from a Gulf background. I was born and brought up in Gulf. So the big problem that I faced at that particular point of time was that everything was concrete, everything was a particular set, you know, an ordered set. I am somebody who is wearing lens right now, you know. So your vision is short-sighted. You can never get a view beyond a certain point. There are many children who have these problems growing in urban cities. And to tell you the truth, I hated architecture, you know, or what I imagined it to be. And I wanted to run far away from it as much as possible. And the college also never satisfied in some sense, you know, like, you know, they were teaching it to become a professional. And among peers also, it was very difficult, you know, to tell something. You are also shy to tell something like, you know, like, buddy, I don't feel like I'm fitting in this concept. But then, thankfully, the guardian of Indian architecture himself, Laurie Baker, I had a chance visit with him. And certain things which he said made sense to me, you know. So, that that helped me a lot, you know, to reconsider my thought process about architecture, you know. For me, architecture is butchery. So, the Gandhi of architecture, Laurie Baker ji, you know, told that, you know, like, if somebody continues butchering in such a sense, you know, everybody wants to live, you know, so butchery is also necessary. Everybody wants shelter. So, some things always make way for one or another thing. So, if you can manage to, you know, salvage something while you're doing it, can you make a symbiotic relationship? Even today, that is my what I'm searching for. So it is not just about earth architecture, but it is also about waste. It is about utilizing the waste that is around you. But in a sense where, you know, like, it's aesthetics is something which is something which is changing. The general perceptions of aesthetics should change.
Especially, so that's what you're trying to do.
Yes, that is what we are trying to do.
So, what was the biggest challenge you faced while you were building this firm in the initial days or even right now?
The biggest challenge I faced was my initial days itself, you know, because see, right now there is something moving. The wheel has started to move. There is some momentum that I gained. Initially, I was alone, you know, as I said, you know, like, only my brothers were there in some sense as my, literally my laborers, you know, my brother and his friends were my laborers, and a few people from Tamil Nadu who are still with me, you know. So initially, it was very difficult to convince that, you know, like, mud brick, everybody thinks, you know, like, something which is very hard and rock-like is the correct type of construction method for your walls. Mud brick is never like that. Mud bricks are always, edges are loose, you know. But as a whole, this thing, it becomes very strong. So many, so my initial days were my toughest, you know. So that was one of my biggest challenges, to convince someone. Literally, I had to talk my way, talk others into it, you know, even convince them, even if they are not convinced. Those kind of things were to push them into this, into this type of architecture or something. Even though I was not very comfortable with it, I had to, because I had to build something to get the ball moving. That was my biggest challenge.
What was the, what is some principle you want to pass on to your students? Is there some core principle or something as an architect, as a mentor, teacher? Is there something you want to pass on to your students or, you know, people who look upon you?
The one basic thing that drives me is that we are here on borrowed time. Our time is finite on this planet. And but everybody needs shelters, you know. So it is natural for us to, you know, destroy natural habitat to make way for our shelters. Especially, we are a big species, you know. We are the the most popular species, you know, dominating species, if we can say that. This makes a big problem, you know, that you know, like, so, but Earth has, I believe, I sincerely believe that Earth can cater to all our needs, but not our greeds. You know, like, Earth can give enough, you know. The biriyani is there for everybody, but not if somebody wants to, you know, like, literally make a mess out of it, you know, the ones who jump up the line or something like that. Because you have money doesn't mean you own any resource. That is one big thing which I have seen. Like, everything is regulated in other fields. In architecture or construction, there is no regulation, you know. Even now, because of COVID, you know, people have, even before COVID, I have heard that our Kerala Sarkar has made regulation in the number of luxurious marriages, you know, like wedding, those kind of things, you know. But there is never has there never has been any regulation in what you build, how much you utilize and everything, which is the biggest threat to our ecology. So there are other living beings, other ecology, leave and let leave is the philosophy that I would tell my fellow beings. But still you are an artist, you have to make a wonderful this thing, but you can make it with this you know, like wasted materials, adapt your use and all those things. That is is what I genuinely feel that we should be pursuing strongly. We should never buy a grill which is new. We should always buy the scrap, you know. There is enough for scrap for us to scorch from.
So is these the changes you want to see in the contemporary approach to earth architecture, whatever you have said right now, or is there more changes you want to see or experiment in it?
There are many changes. Changes are a constant, you know, like you can't get away from changes. That is a big constant in this kind of in particular world. You have to continuously keep on changing because recently I lost a project, you know, in spite of now gaining a lot of popularity amongst my friends and fellow citizens. I recently lost a project, you know. That is something which made me very grounded, feel very grounded that I am going in the right direction. So now I am known for doing with mud break and everything. So I recently devised a project in Bangalore. Where it is made with tires. So the walls are made with tires. See, the tire is a wonderful matrix. Inside the matrix, you can fill with soil. In New Mexico and all, there is Michael Doyle who is doing fantastic work with this.
Okay.
So I wanted to create a wonderful aesthetic creation with tires. There are a lot of discarded tires. See, nowadays we use tubeless tires.
Yes.
So tubeless tires means, you know, you discard it. There is no more retreading happening. So that means there are millions of acres being filled with these waste tires, or somebody is burning them and polluting the atmosphere. Now imagine, soil is also getting something scarce. You can't always get soil in the urban areas. But there are a lot of tires. So I made a project. I made a wonderful project, a residence with tires in such a way that there are even trees growing through them, so that there is a symbiotic relationship with the, you are able to grow with your limited resource. So the client, the next day after my presentation, during the presentation he kept quiet, his wife was there, his child was there. The next day I knew that something went wrong, you know. So when you get the call immediately next day itself, you know that I want a meeting with you know it is going in a very wrong direction. So the client came to me and told, Vinu, I took 2 years to convince my wife to go for an earth building, a rammed earth or a CATB building. And then you brought up a building to be made with tires.
Okay.
So he was telling me, this is you know, this is not possible. That is what he was telling me. What happened is, when that scenario happened, you know, I told him that, sir, if I'm doing today with tire, tomorrow I might do with human waste, you know. You know, maybe you come after 2 years, we might be doing it with human waste, because that we are producing it. You get it? So I want to change that perspective. You get it? That suddenly, maybe you see, it's like, and these materials last for a long period of time. None of my buildings are something like, okay, it will vanish off after 10 years or something, you know. The life is guaranteed at least for 100 years. And to tell you the truth, most of my grandpa was also a builder, you know. I'm third generation engineer. Whatever my grandpa built, I had demolished and rebuilt it. So every time the uncles were saying, grandpa built the toilets more, we have to change this thing, we had to change that thing. Even though he was a visionary in his own sense at that particular point of time. Our changes change. Our requirements change. You know, we always have different requirements. Even after 5 years, you say that, okay, the toilet I built was just too small. Nowadays we have that, this and everything.
Yes.
So this makes us to improve our particular environment. And when you have the means, let's say nowadays we have been plundering our natural resources to such an extent that we eat non-veg almost daily. We build construction almost, you know, like within 10 years. Before it was like, okay, my grandpa built it, and after only 60, 70 years, we used to do construction. Now, these things have, like a car, for example, a car, you remember, like probably your parents had an old Maruti or Premier Padmini. But today, you change your car almost within 5 years or 3 years. Now, don't think that this is because you earned a lot of money. That is your foolish understanding of it. It's because we are plundering natural resources to such an extent that this has been all produced, you know. Somebody is taking it from the earth. When somebody is taking from the earth, they are not paying any value for it. You should understand. When mineral extraction is happening, when your steel is being produced, they are not paying money to earth. They are paying amongst themselves. The government is getting paid, or somebody is getting paid. But these are things that are finite in our planet. After a certain point of time, your rivers will not replenish. Your rivers will run dry. Your ocean will be a garbage bin, you know. So what is the price? Is it good enough that you are having a new house every 5 years, or is it good enough that you are having a new car every 3 years? You get it? These are all things that we have to understand. And I just saw somebody writing about tire finish and all. Trust me, I do not make anything which is not art worthy. I don't make anything. Because I use tires doesn't mean that the building has to be shoddy or shabby. It means that the building has to be beautiful beyond your conventional building creation. That is what I aim for.
So you were talking a lot about natural resources. So every buildings reflect your building designs reflects upon how we have to coexist, right? So how does your designing process happen?
Recently, what happened is one of my recently completed residence, IHA, was a residence known for its bamboo use. You know, bamboo was supplied to me by Cosford, who are literally like my parents or any of this generation's parents, you know. So Elijah teacher taught me, and Sergeant sir was really a great guru for us. And so Sergeant sir, you know, graciously gave me pre-treated bamboo for this particular building, which was near. But the real wonderful part of the building was not the bamboo facade or the craftsmanship that I created in the building. The real truth of the building, that it was on a swamp. It was in a field. Trivandrum is a place where there is hills and swamps. So this was the last swamp in that particular vicinity. Low-lying area. So the client or whatever the people advise is just to fill that land and, you know, like utilize, build pillars on top and everything. So anyway, I had to do pile foundation because it is a swamp. So I told the clients that why not leave with the swamp? The snakes are not going to fly up and bite you. You know, you will leave in a certain level above the swamp. I will make sure that it is protected. The swamp is also protected. That it is protected from you, and you are protected in some sense from swamp. And all those things. We are creating an environment symbiotic for life all up and life below, you know, which is very important. We think that okay, this is dirty, this is bad. No, I created the aesthetics in such a way that it is beautiful. Life continues in its own sense, and its noises, its sounds and beauty was there. Get it? So inspiration comes from there. Inspiration is to leave and let live. These are also animals which you need. These are all the things which you need. You have a lot of gardens in your apartment, isn't it? Like you are living in Kochi or I don't know where it is. But you will not find
butterflies. I have a house.
You will not find butterflies much. Correct. You know why? Butterflies are very sensitive to the kind of manure and fertilizers that you have to put for these flowering plants. The natural flowers, the weeds which you hate, the weeds which you hate to walk on are the ones which really attract the natural beings of that particular area. You have to grow. You have to let, you know, if you have a 5-cent property, at least give a 3 meter by 3 meter, 100 square foot, for nature to live that way and don't go into it, you know, don't destroy it, you know, don't attack it, don't manicure it, you know. Some of these landscapes are manicured gardens.
Yes.
They do not give life. They might just look good for your photographs. They are not correct. Really good.
Correct.
For the ecology.
So someone has asked how difficult it is to get the clientele. Is it difficult to convince your clients, maybe?
I don't live for clientele, first of all. No, I don't, that is not my first priority, you know. Even if when projects were very less and scarce, I used to think, why should I build for this guy? You know, better than that, go and get some petrol in some petrol pump, you know. This is something which is very, which is harmful to a lot of animals. Like I told you, architecture is butchery.
Correct.
It kills. The second you put a shovel, whether I'm an earth architect or not, it kills. You are engaging in, you know, like genocide in some sense. Whenever you are getting into a property, there are so much of life that is happening there.
Yeah.
So the big problem for me is that even when a project is coming, yes, I need to earn money. I need to feed my family. I need to, you know, make sure that, you know, like it's a good project. It is good for my ego, my well-feeling and all those things. I need that. But will he really protect it and support it is a question that you need. So it is not about, you know, like whether the client. So after a certain point of time, only such clients come. There is a client of mine. He recently received, you know, like something, an honorable mention of being an eco-friendly citizen by the state government. This man, he is a primary school, government primary school teacher, taught us to how to take bath with 5 mugs of water. Because I am this Gulf fellow, you know, I my life is not eco-friendly. I definitely sit under the shade for more minutes than required. But this person showed us, you know, so there are certain clients that is there. It is not like all the earth is populated by these idiots. No, there are wonderful, wonderful people who are even more, you know, like earth conscious than us. Another client of mine, like Ramanujan sir and all, like they have been really, really advocating this process for all their life.
Okay.
So when you ask, where do you get these clients from? There are clients next to you. You get it? There are genuine parties next to you. It's not that hard to find. It's not that hard once you believe that this is a crime. Otherwise, whatever I am building is a crime if I don't leave an iota, because already it is a crime. If at least I don't give that 5% back, you know, then why are we doing it?
Okay, so as an architecture, tell us, who is Vinu Daniel beyond this profession?
Beyond my profession?
Beyond your profession.
beyond my profession. I am, you know, like that leave and let live came from the human being, no? So the truth is, yeah.
So what are the things you hold most dear?
Evolution. Evolution and understand. Because I feel that modern man is something that is supposed to, you know, understand all these things. You know, we should understand that what industrialization has cost us, you know. What littering has cost us, what, you know, purging everything has cost us. We need to understand that. So in some sense, you know, like, and I am a vagabond because of my profession in some sense. I don't have a home, I don't have an office. So I am literally, right now I am in a hotel room. So I literally keep running. I am on the road most of the time. So
there is some questions your fans or well-wishers have asked. Which software did you use for bamboo work?
I generally use both Rhino and SketchUp. I do not use the Grasshopper because I make my parametric equations myself.
Okay. There's someone who has asked you, walls with tires, can we get a glimpse of it?
I don't have any picture at this point of time. I'm so sorry.
So regarding the place, someone has asked, how do you handle at site? I mean, bamboo, mud, and exposed brick.
For that, I have a small story. When I was having initially mobile, there was not much to see. There were only these games to play. So there is this game called Fish, in Samsung. All the Samsung Galaxy mobile, you will find that. So I used to play and make some 500, 500 points and all. And I used to think that I was pretty good myself,
Okay.
But then my cousin came from Gulf.
Okay.
And he asked me, Ada, what is his score? And I said 500. And I thought that it will be a good response. He said, Adi, that is a very bad score. 5,000 is my score, And I couldn't believe it. Then I saw him play once. Okay.
Okay.
Then the very next day, I could reach somewhere around 2,000. So I used to think, what changed? It is just your attitude. Mud and bamboo are around you. The truth is, the steel you procure or the concrete you procure or the ideology you procure or Gorbachev ideology, all of those things, these are actually far. Mud and bamboo is very near to you, isn't it?
Correct. Yes.
The things which you study in your book are actually far. These are all things which came in later. So mud, bamboo, and all those materials. I work. My God is my land. That is my God.
Okay.
I don't have any other God. So that is what nature has bestowed upon us. My rivers are my gods. My stones are my gods. My mud is my God, and all those things are my gods.
Okay, I'm not pretty good with all these questions. I don't even understand. What do you think about limestone plaster instead of Venept plaster? Is that right? I'm saying.
I have no clue. People assume that I know so many things. I have no clue. I'm very thankful that a lot of them are concerned like that. A very big thank you for all this. All the comments, only comments, and thank you a lot.
The final question I want to ask you is, you have active projects across the country right now, right? What is the future of Vinu Daniel and Wallmakers? What are the new upcoming projects, something interesting coming up?
I'm doing schools. That is something which was never in my repertoire before. So I'm doing a school in Coimbatore. I am doing a treehouse community in Shoolagiri, I'm very happy. Tree houses are something which our people love a lot. But in the process, we destroy the tree, I am planning to make a tree house for the first time. It's a first attempt. I'm planning to build a very beautiful tree house without damaging much the tree, with allowing it to be symbiotic with the tree is what I'm trying to do at this point of time. And being a vagabond has its advantages. You are not stuck anywhere. You are not stuck for a, thing. You are not stuck for your chai you get in the morning, So these are all luxuries in some sense. That in some sense helps.
Okay. So thank you so much, Vinu. It was a very, very informative session.
I show something?
Please do.
This is the tire. I don't know how I can show more clear or something like that.
Okay.
This is the those are tires actually. This is a picture of it. I don't know how. This is a picture of it. This is kind of getting embarrassing to tell you the truth. So this was how the inside of it would look. So you can see the tire walls, which is laid with mud and lime. So I plan to do something with mud and lime.
So thank you so much, Vinu. Thank you for being in this session. So many of them have asked us to share this in IGTV. So for sure, we'll be sharing this. It has been very informative for the architects. And as you said, the important concept, live and let live. So I think that is something we all can take it forward in our life. Thank you so much. Thank you for being there. All the best with all your wonderful projects. God bless.
Thank you.
Bye, Vinu. Bye-bye. So thank you so much for watching. So today we had Vinu Daniel, who's an architect. So valare, valare different aayittulla field like aanu nammal innu kandathu. Earth architecture, being friendly. So many things he said is actually touched our hearts. Live and let live. Kore concepts nammal orikkala aalochikkatha kore kaaryangal he put a light to it. So thank you so much for watching. I will be sharing this in my IGTV. Bye-bye.